Good morning. My name is Martin Dichkanz. I'm a stroke neurologist from Munich, LMU. And I'm here at the third European Stroke Organization conference in Prague. I'm here with Dr. Kwon from Seoul, Korea. He's the principal investigator of the Picasso trial, and it's a great privilege to have the opportunity to speak to him here and get his sort of view on the trial and share it with you as an audience. So Dr. Kwon, could you give us an idea of the rationale behind this trial? What was the primary question of your trial?
So we wanted to prove the efficacy of and the safety of a protocol in the ischemic patient with high risk of cerebral hemorrhage. Because of standard statin therapy, we increase the risk of bleeding complications slightly. So in that specific population, we have the concern is increased. So we developed the better management strategy using protocol.
And I understand that these were patients with ischemic stroke or transient ischemic attack, excluding patients with cardioembolic stroke, right?
Yeah.
Okay. And what was the intervention exactly? It was just protocol compared to placebo.
It is open-label blind endpoint trial. So we compared the protocol treatment versus the no treatment.
But patients were on statin therapy.
Yes, statin therapy will be recommended by our protocol as a guideline. So we about 70% of our patients have taking statin.
And these were patients with a high risk of intracerebral hemorrhage. Mm-hmm. So patients with either a past intracerebral hemorrhage or multiple microbleeds on neuroimaging, if I'm right.
Yeah.
Could you give us an idea of how long you followed patients? So what was the follow-up interval?
So mean follow-up period of our patient is about 2 years. So during the period, the patient taking both medications with standard therapy. So we captured the major cardiovascular event, such as stroke, MI, and vascular death.
So it was a combined primary endpoint consisting of stroke, myocardial infarction, or cardiovascular death. Is that right?
Yeah.
Vascular death.
Yeah.
Okay. And could you give us an idea of the results of this trial?
So we fortunately, protocol significantly reduced the occurrence of major cardiovascular event. And it significantly reduced the incidence of a stroke and ischemic stroke too.
So protocol reduced the rate of both the combined vascular endpoint
and each endpoint too.
And each endpoint too, including stroke as a whole, including ischemic stroke and hemorrhagic stroke.
No, the incidence of hemorrhagic stroke and the vascular death is similar in both treatment.
Okay, good. And what about safety?
Safety, fortunately, we have no safety concerns about the protocol treatment. Actually, the protocol is a kind of a CETP activator, so it reduced the HDL level significantly after treatment. So in that region, protocol has not been used currently, so we assessed the safety issue about the level of HDL and the occurrence of a major cardiovascular event. So the lowest level quartile, also the benefit effect of a protocol continued even in lowest level of HDL.
Well, thank you. This is very interesting. The last question I would have is, what do you think are the immediate consequences of your trial for clinical practice, if any? Will your trial already merge into a change of clinical practice in your country, in Asia? Are you advocating that this should merge into a change of practice globally around the world? Or do we need additional trials in Asian populations and outside in other populations?
So as I know, this is a first clinical trial in a protocol in ischemic stroke population. Previous era, the protocol showed efficacy in the prevention of atherosclerosis or the restenosis after coronary stenting, but have never been done large clinical trial. So we should confirm of that this kind of beneficial effect of protocol in ischemic stroke patient too. So our population is a very selected population. So most of them are the small vessel disease. So therefore, the protocol can be applied to generally. So we need the protocol or the similar CETP activator should be evaluated in the useful list in the prevention of ischemic stroke or cardiovascular event in ischemic stroke population.
So you advocate additional trials, targeted trials in patients, for example, with small vessel stroke and in other populations of patients with stroke, also including non-Asian populations.
Yes, absolutely.
Before implementing protocol in clinical practice,
yeah.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Well, thank you very much for giving us this interview. It was a great pleasure. Thank you also to all the investigators mm-hmm. in your team and to your patients, of course, and for presenting the results here at the Third European Stroke Organization Conference in Prague. Thank you very much.
Thank you.